it on, baby. Come on. All right. We have had enough. Thank you, everyone, for making it. Those who are from outside of Chennai, can you please raise your hands here? Wow. Next time, Juhu Chowparty. All right. No, it's really beautiful. I know this is the only time when I actually get to see all of you every year. And I guess for most of you, it remains the same. So thank you, everyone, for making it. On behalf of iSpirit and everybody else involved in making this happen, thank you so much. Without, you know, I think everybody has the eternity. Do you guys know what we are doing today? Other than a lot of time pass? We are doing a lot of interesting stuff. Immediately after the, this one, I'll pass on the baton to Pallav, who'll walk us through a series called Show and Tell, a few companies that will showcase how to make product as their marketing channel, and that's going to be very, very interesting. So I'll hand it over to him in a bit. But there's one very interesting thing that I wanted to share. Can I have Girish Prabhu identify himself in the audience? Everybody, look at him, please. Okay, so the reason you're looking at him, a big round of applause for him though, and I'll tell you why. So Girish attended SASEX last year, and there was a round table in which he participated. And where is Suresh? Where is Suresh? Suresh was a bad guy then, and he tore him down into pieces just for one simple reason. He had a great product, but he wasn't willing to quit his job and was pursuing it as a side project. And it was me, Suresh, and a couple of other folks who literally tore him into pieces for doing so. He actually quit his job and sent me an email a couple of days later saying that he did that. And out of fear, I didn't reply. I just didn't acknowledge. And today he met me and he's apparently doing great. He runs a very cute company called Instio, which is into collecting a lot of instant feedback at point of sale and check-in check-out counters at hotels, and he's doing really, really well. So a good round of applause for him. This is the kind of stories we are trying to create at SASEX. Say that again. Is it? So am I. Can you see tears here? Yeah. So this is exactly. Yeah, I know. So this is exactly what SASEX stands for, and I hope we can do more and more of these. Over to you, Pallav, and we so look forward to a great session.
People from behind the podium almost makes me feel like a political person. I'm not used to that. So let me start with a couple of questions. How many of you have used referral marketing before here? Raise your hands. That's about 8 of you. Okay. How many of you have been successful with that?
Yes, we have successful.
Referral marketing. Okay. So the most basic form of referral marketing is, hey, either you have a form on your website and you say, you know what, refer 5 of your friends, and you let them sort of put in some tags or a love message, so to speak, and you send it to these 5 friends. Anybody else who's tried a different thing apart from the guys here, obviously? How many of you have used your customer to get another customer through any other means? Okay. Speak of some of the most interesting things you've done. Just shout out. We can hear you. Anyone?
Refill tweets.
Okay, tweets. Fair enough. Something else?
Ask him to deliver a webinar for us.
Deliver a webinar, okay. Something else?
Testimonials,
okay.
Sharing the commission.
Sharing the commission, okay. So, out of all these four, sharing the commission is the only one where there's an outcome-driven metric. Where for a fact that you know this customer got you X four customers, which you're able to measure quantitatively, and that customer further gets you more customers. So if this customer has delivered one webinar, Aditya, how many webinars can you expect him to deliver week upon week?
Series. We have done 4 or 5 webinars till now. changing customer. But you are right.
Okay. And is there a metric you follow saying that from this one customer, consistently over a span of time, I'm getting X customers, and each of those customers goes back into this funnel at the top of the funnel? Okay. Anybody who solved that problem? Think of random ideas. What would you do? Let's say you have, all of you have X amount of customers today, and you have a product, and it's incredibly difficult to get customers. We all agree that, right? But okay, so that's again the commission part of it, like some incentive. But again, that does not guarantee, if somebody's paying you, he doesn't mind paying you because he's getting value. And for him to save that $10, $20, $50, $100, is that enough to get him to the next customer?
Some extra features.
Extra features, how do you quantitatively measure that? This feature helped me get, convert every customer to evangelist. Okay, so here's the fallacy. If you're selling a B2B product, most of the guys who are buying are not paying from their product. If unless you give them an Amazon gift voucher, it doesn't matter because that goes to his pocket. Otherwise, the company's paying for it, especially if you're selling to managers and not CEOs. Give me more ideas, guys. Okay, if somebody asks you to sign up every attendee here in SaaSX and somebody gave you a fancy form, would you do that? We'll all mark you as spam. Hey, there's free food and beer though. Very good point. How do you do that?
So, take an example of a CRM and refer your partners so you can manage your partners as well through the same industry, right? So, you can adding your marketing.
Okay, that's not clear. But let's say if I were to hypothesize on this, all of us run some CRMs. We are about 200 founders in this room. Okay, and let's say in similar industries but non-competing, hypothetically. If I say, hey, you know what, I've got 250,000 qualified emails in my database, developers, JavaScript developers. If you're building something for a JavaScript developer, I can help you trade emails on certain credits. You give me another 250,000, I'll give you my 250,000 within the bounds of privacy. Would that be useful?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Now think on these random tangents. Again, people don't pay from their pockets in enterprises. If the company saves money, they don't get much. I mean, unless you're saving millions of dollars, in which case they get a career promotion. So Dropbox is a beautiful example. So think of some of the products, like think of Slack. What are the bottom-up adoption products where one guy got into the product and he horizontally spread it? Think of Yammer, think of Slack, where one guy brings in more guys within the team. And then he loves the product so much that he becomes the influencer even outside the team. What are the five products you can think of? Think of WhatsApp. So collaboration is fundamentally viral. If you don't think of collaboration, and if you have to think of more B2B, which is the space that we are in, sort of, what are some of these unique examples that you can think of?
Trello
is again collaboration. Trello project management, collaboration is the same. Sketch how? Okay, so that's based on the file format, fair enough. So here, because the same file format is there, like Autodesk again, everybody in the team is using that, but for that to become, your product has to be the de facto standard in that.